Point Click Hell's playthrough of Blackwell Convergence, Part 4. Alright, let's head to Cubestar Productions and
come on, let's get going.
Yeah, let's blow this popsicle stand.
Come in. Oh, hello. Again?
I'd like to know the truth about Frank's death.
What do you mean? I told you everything I know.
Not everything. He didn't have a heart attack, did he?
Oh, I love seeing sweat on a pretty girl's brow.
Look, I gave my statement. I don't see why I should tell you anything.
Monique, I'm a writer. We like to exaggerate the truth sometimes.
Yes, what are you getting at?
Let's say I wanted to embellish Frank's story. That instead of dying of a heart attack, he may be choked to death under mysterious circumstances.
Rosangela, Frank died of a heart attack. He didn't choke to death.
Are you sure?
Positive. If he mysteriously choked to death, and the press got wind of it, the scandal would ruin this company. It's much easier to tell the press that he died of a heart attack. He had no close family, he had no close friends to speak of. Nobody loses. I trust we understand each other, and I won't have to call my lawyer.
Leave it, kid. We don't want a legal battle.
No, I have all the information I need. I don't know if she was serious about calling a lawyer, but I really don't want to risk it. Thanks for the chat, Monique.
Sure.
All right, well, seems like Monique isn't willing to talk to us too much, so... Try the Mineta Tavern again. Oh, there's Claude. Let's talk to Claude.
Claude?
Rosangela Blackwell, the writer. Come on over. Have a drink.
You remember me.
Who could forget someone who could down 3 glasses of claret in half an hour?
Bit early to be drinking.
Says the woman who had to be carried home the other night by an old Indian lady. My opening is tonight, and I intend to be well and truly plastered. It's the only way I'll be able to bear it.
I'd like to talk to you about your work.
I'd love to, but I'm not drunk enough.
Bye, Claude.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Well, he doesn't seem too willing to talk. Ah, what the hell, let's go to the park gallery. Talk to Josie.
There. It's her. I knew it. Now look at that and tell me this isn't a coincidence. Stupid old hag. We'll find you. Just see if we don't.
I'd better not touch it. Josie definitely looks like the woman from the other night, but she looks sad. It's just a lighthouse. I wonder which one. That's Josie Park. She's... Hi, Josie.
Yes?
Hi, Josie. Can I talk to you for a bit more?
I'm kind of...
I'd like to know more about that painting there.
Oh, the Dark Lady. It's different than his other paintings. I'm worried the investors won't like it, but Claude insists. What do you want to know?
What can you tell me about the Dark Lady?
Well, it's different, isn't it? Claude's work is mostly abstract, but this is actually of a specific subject.
Did Claude ever say why?
No, but she's definitely striking.
She strikes all right. I still got the scars.
Claude gets weird when I ask who she is or why he put her in front of the Roosevelt Island Lighthouse. I figure it's just one of those eccentric artist things.
The Roosevelt Island Lighthouse, huh? It's been a while since I've been over there.
You mentioned something about investors.
Oh yes, the Meltzer Foundation. They paid for everything, the renovation, the lights, everything. I've got to pay them back eventually, of course, but still.
Tell me about Claude.
Oh, I found him on the street. Literally. He made his living painting street scenes and selling them to tourists. But he's too much of a genius for that. Don't you think so?
Oh, yes, definitely.
See? I knew he was the right choice for this gallery.
How much do these paintings cost?
Oh, I can't reveal the prices until the public exhibit. But if you're interested in any of them, let me know. I'll discount it for you.
Oh, no thanks. I'm not really in the market for any art right now.
Translation, she can't afford it.
Oh, all right. But if you change your mind, let me know.
Where can I find Claude?
As if we didn't
Knowing know. Him, he's probably preparing for tonight.
Preparing?
You know, glug glug.
He's hitting the sauce.
Ah. So, how's everything going?
Oh, you know, busy, busy. This is my first public opening. I want it to be just right.
Do you know anything about Frank Lyon's death?
Spooky, isn't it? Imagine someone just dying of a heart attack right in front of you. Poor Monique must have been traumatized.
Yeah, traumatized all the way to the bank.
Can you tell me anything about the Meltzer Foundation?
Oh, those guys are a godsend. Without them, I never would have been able to open this place. I presented them with my plan for the gallery, and poof, they wrote me a check.
That's pretty generous.
I never thought I was venture capital material, but go figure. I'll have to pay them back, of course, and give them a percentage of our income, but look around. It's my life's dream realized.
How well do you know Monique Stallman?
She's a nice lady, although I don't think she'll be back. She didn't seem to really appreciate Claude's work.
I'm sorry.
No worries. It's not everybody's cup of tea.
Have you ever heard of a place called the Minetta?
Nope. Sorry.
Have you ever heard of Joe Gould or the Joe Gould Fund?
Nope. Sorry.
Huh. Helps to be thorough.
Thanks, Josie. I'd better get going.
Sure, Rosangela. I'll see you at the opening tonight.
Actually, we probably should head back to the apartment and look up where the Meltzer Foundation is. Search.
Come on, let's get going.
It's about time. Let's scram.
Scram? All right. Let's go check out the lighthouse first.
Here we are. I don't see any ghosts. You sense anything?
Nope, seems clean to me.
Really? You sure?
I said there's nothing here. Well, no ghosts anyway.
Alright, let's check this out.
I read a book about this place years ago. Nobody uses this lighthouse anymore. It's just a historic monument.
Go check out the Meltzer Foundation, then. Maybe it'll hit a few leads.
Yes?
Hi. Is this the Meltzer Foundation?
Yes.
Oh, good. I was hoping to ask you a few questions.
Paul, this one's for you.
Hmm? Oh, sure thing. Come on over and step into my office.
Charlie Meltzer is played by Dave Gilbert,
so,
the producer
I'm Paul
and owner
Meltzer,
of Watch
and my Films. Silent partner over there is my brother, Charlie.
Rosangela Blackwell.
A pleasure. So, what can we do for you?
I was hoping to talk to you about what you do here.
Really? Well, well, well. We're moving up in the world, Charlie.
Uh-huh.
So, Rosangela, you with a newspaper?
I'm sort of freelance.
Struggling, eh? Well, that's what the Meltzer Foundation is all about. Isn't that right, Charlie?
Uh-huh.
Well, ask away.
I was wondering what you do here.
You know, I wonder that myself. Hey, Charlie, what do we do here?
We give away money, Paul.
That's right. We're into private investments. We grant risk-free capital to struggling businesses.
You really just give away money?
No, not exactly.
It's about giving money away wisely.
You heard the man. If you want the lowdown on what we do, just ask.
Tell me more about the foundation.
Let's say you have a brilliant idea for a business, but you've made some mistakes in the past. You've got bad credit or were in debt for a long time. No reputable bank in the country would give you a loan. Or if they did, they'd charge you a fortune in interest. But not us. We believe in a second chance. We'll loan you the money to kickstart your business in return for a share of the profits. If your business takes off, wonderful, we both win. If not, we're the one who pays for it.
Have you ever heard of Joe Gould or the Joe Gould Fund?
No, sorry.
Have you ever been to a bar called the Minetta?
No, sorry.
Pays to be thorough.
Do you know anything about Frank Lyons, the actor?
Of course. Can you believe it? A heart attack at his age. He looked healthy. Of course, who knows what kind of drugs those actors take?
Are you familiar with Monique Stallman or CubeStar Films?
Why do you ask?
No reason. Josie Park told me that you invested in her gallery.
You know Josie. How's she doing?
She's fine, I guess.
We're both rooting for her, right, Charlie?
Sure.
Well, thanks for talking to me. I might be back later.
Sure thing. Here, take my card. If you have any questions, just email.
Oh, so you're on Bmail too.
Isn't everybody?
Wonder where Jerry ran off to.
God, did you see that chick walk? She waddles like a duck.
Huh?
Our reporter friend. She's kind of your type.
What do you mean?
Yeesh, Charlie. Come up for air. She walked right past your desk.
I didn't see any duck.
Never mind.
Stay put, kid. I'm going to snoop around. I've got no idea what this thing is.
Hey, my internet just went down. Stupid
wireless.
Oh, you
must have Wi-Fi.
It should come up again in a minute.
Hey, Charlie, did you turn on the AC?
No, not me.
Finally, the internet's back up. Hey, Charlie, what's that Bmail password again?
Don't you remember anything? It's tennis53. Just write it down.
No way. Someone might find it.
Yeah, I think
hey,
that's all we need.
Oh, come on. Bmail.
It does the job.
At least we have a real internet connection. Although, I don't trust this wireless crap.
So now we have Charles, Paul Meltzer's internet address. And let's head back home. All right, let's go in and look into Mr. Meltzer's email. Let's check the card. PaulM@bmail.com. Okay.
My computer. It's not...
Damn it, I always do that. Tennis 53, just like he said. Alright, Josie Park, Charles Meltzer, out of the office. Okay, so we know that Tomo. Got his, well, obviously, since Paul's Meltzer's email is Paul M. Charles Meltzer should be Charles M. Now we just need to find out his password, and we got a hint. So we just need to look out for that in the future. All right. All right, I think that's enough for this episode. We'll see you for part 5. Thanks for watching.